we've spoken previously about the cost or perhaps lack thereof as it relates to moving from Salesforce Classic to Salesforce Lightning. Let's peel things back just a little bit further. What are the steps? What are the things that are involved in making that transition?
So now you're in this world where you've got the classic page with the fields and the related lists that still exists in the Lightning world, but you've got this what's called a Lightning page, and it surrounds the page layout with a variety of UI capabilities where you can put in components that can show different sets of data. You can launch flows from screens. You can show a whole lot more data than you could before and do actions from that. Whereas in Classic, you would have to switch a page or go to a different tab. Now it's all contained in one real nice UI. But from the technical side, I think Apex and Visual Force pages are slightly different or maybe the same.
So yeah, on the technical side, if you have a lot of custom Apex, all that has for the most part stayed the same. Lightning has really improved the capabilities of Apex and brought it, given it a little more functionality. Visual Force pages will continue to work. They may not be in the same styling, and you might want to go through an effort to make it look like a seamless experience. But they should continue to work, and you should definitely do some testing before you force users into the Lightning experience. So JavaScript custom buttons do need to be, you do need to find another way to build them out. You can't just convert them. You either need to convert them to a Lightning action, a screened flow, or even a Visual Force page. But you won't be able to use those in the Lightning experience.
Is there a guarantee that all of my old AppExchange packages that I've had since 2007 are going to work?
No. You should do an evaluation on whether your AppExchange packages will continue to work. The best way to do that is to go to the AppExchange and find the listing, the public listing, not through your Salesforce org, and see if it has the Lightning ready bolt.
Yep.
If it's Lightning ready, then you should be okay migrating. There could be a little bit of effort depending on how the package was implemented and how they got ready for Lightning. You may have to change some of the configuration.
We could also sandbox it, right? Put it in the sandbox, install it, turn on Lightning, yep, and see if it blows up.
Always a good idea.
I'll add one final thing to this. So there's the technical aspect. We've made all the changes under the hood, but we don't want to just put this in front of our users and say, hey guys, here you go. So I would strongly encourage organizations that are making this transition to really put some thought into how they're going to put this in their users' hands. Don't just turn it on and say, hey guys, I'm done, good luck. There really needs to be kind of a training or a retraining within the Lightning paradigm for it to be successful.
Yep. It's not like the Best Buy commercial where you just start hitting buttons, right? You gotta do a strategy and figure out how it should go.
Yeah. Yeah. I find one of the best ways to do that is to have like your super users, right? Identify users within certain groups and give them access to Lightning as is and see if they can break it, because they will.
Yeah. And tagging onto that just a little bit too, I think that this is a great place to do a pilot. And when you do a pilot, I would take some of the super users and the not so super users and try to get both ends of the spectrum. Form maybe just a small little steering committee, give it to them for a week, 2 weeks, meet a couple of times, get their feedback, and make your tweaks and modifications from there.